Please subscribe and click on the bell icon to get my latest updates first. Hey guys, this is Kamlesh Swargam and welcome to my channel. I have got very good news for you guys. I am going to start free giveaways on my channel. I will tell you all about it in between and at the end of this video. So please watch the entire video carefully. Coming back to our video, I will be telling you the specifications, cost and features of the top 10 phones in India under Rs 20,000 in November 2020. So let's explore it. Number 10. Vivo V17, Rs 17,990. Vivo V17 is a good-looking smartphone finished in a fancy paint job. At the front, it has a hole-punch selfie camera which makes it look modern. It has a 6.44-inch display with thin bezels on the sides. It also packs in a 4500 mAh battery, but it isn't very bulky at 176 grams. It sports a quad camera setup at the back with a 48 megapixel primary shooter. Powering the Vivo V17 is the Qualcomm Snapdragon 675 system on chip, which is relatively dated. It is paired with 8GB of RAM, which makes multitasking easy. There is 128GB of storage, which is plenty for an average user. The Vivo V17 runs FunTouch OS 9.2 on top of Android 9. The battery life is good and the smartphone can last over a day easily. Camera performance of Vivo V17 is very good in daylight, but low light photos have some noise. Night mode helps deliver a better shot. Low light video recording is below average. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at Rs 17,990. Number 9. Realme X2, Rs 17,999. Realme X2 is powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 730G system on chip, making it the first smartphone under Rs 20,000 to have it. It's designed around the Realme XT, with nearly identical ports and button placement. It also features a dewdrop notch with a large Super AMOLED display and an in-display fingerprint sensor. The phone features two nano SIM card slots and a dedicated slot for a micro SD card. It's available in three variants, with the first starting at Rs 16,999. ColorOS offers lots of customization and runs smoothly. Gaming performance is especially good and we didn't notice any overheating issues either. The bottom speaker gets loud thanks to Dolby Atmos enhancements. The front camera is a 32 megapixel sensor and captures good quality selfies under good light. The rear quad cameras are exactly the same as the Realme XT. The main 64 megapixel sensor shoots sharp images in daylight and nightscape works well for low light shots. The wide angle camera is competent too, given enough light. There's also two 2 megapixel cameras for depth and macro shots. Battery life is decent as the 4000 mAh battery easily lasts for more than a day. However, it does have very fast charging, thanks to VOOC Flash Charge 4.0 standard, which can fully charge the battery in little over an hour. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at Rs 17,999. Reminder, watch this video till the end for info about giveaways. Number 8. Samsung Galaxy M31, Rs 16,740. Samsung Galaxy M31 sports a big 6.4-inch display and has a water drop notch at the top. It has thin bezels around the AMOLED display, which helps it stand out among the competition. The Galaxy M31 is comfortable to hold in the hand, but is a little heavy at 171 grams. The weight of the smartphone is mainly because of the big 6000 mAh battery that it packs. Samsung has equipped the Galaxy M31 with an Equinox 9611 system on chip and gets 6GB of RAM. It has two storage variants to choose from, 64GB and 128GB. The Galaxy M31 is a dual SIM device with support for 4G. It runs Samsung One UI 2.0 on top of Android 10. The Galaxy M31 has a quad camera setup at the back, with the primary being a 64-megapixel shooter. It also houses an 8-megapixel ultra-wide-angle camera, a 5-megapixel macro camera, and a 5-megapixel depth sensor. Daylight camera performance is good, but low-light camera performance was disappointing. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹16,740. Number 7. Poco X2, ₹17,499. Poco X2 offers good value for money with specifications and capabilities that few other companies can't match in the 20,000 market. The design, with its attention-grabbing circular patch on the rear and bright gradient finishes, might be a bit polarizing, but Poco has used Gorilla Glass 5 on the front and the back for durability. You get a large 6.67-inch screen with dual front cameras embedded in a cutout in the top right corner. The display is bright and supports a 120Hz refresh rate as well as HDR10, but we didn't find it to be too vibrant. Performance is very good thanks to the Snapdragon 730G processor, and you can get up to 8GB of RAM with up to 256GB of storage for less than ₹20,000. This phone also boasts of a 64MP primary rear camera, and it took very good stills in the daytime. The night mode also helped low-light photos look good. The wide-angle and macro cameras are less useful but still nice to have. Daytime videos looked good, but quality suffered a lot at night, especially when recording at 4K. Battery life was also quite good, but not spectacular. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹17,499. Number 6. Realme 6 Pro, ₹17,999. Realme 6 Pro is a mid-range flagship featuring the powerful Snapdragon 720G chipset and a quad rear camera setup. It features a 6.6-inch LCD display which produces good colors and brightness. There's no in-display fingerprint sensor, so Realme has used a capacitive one in the power button. There's Face Lock 2, which works very well. Realme has used a modern looking hole punch cutout in the display for the two front cameras. The phone is available with up to 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. The latter is expandable. App and gaming performance is very good, and we didn't face any issue with heating either. The 4300mAh battery easily lasts for a day and a half, and there's 30W fast charging too. The main 64MP camera captures good quality photos in daylight and at night. The night mode comes in handy here. There's a wide-angle camera which is useful, and a macro camera for ultra-close-up shots. The 6 Pro can also shoot videos up to 4K resolution. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹17,999. Reminder: watch this video till the end for info about giveaways. Number 5. Redmi Note 9 Pro Max, ₹15,999. This new smartphone is identical to the Redmi Note 9 Pro and shares a lot of core hardware as well. It sports a big 6.67 inch display with a hole punch at the center of the display towards the top of the panel. It isn't comfortable to use single-handedly as it is tall and bulky. The main reason for the bulk of the smartphone is the big 5020 mAh battery of the smartphone. The Redmi Note 9 Pro Max is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 720G system on chip. It is a capable processor and can handle daily tasks very well. The phone is offered in three variants: 6GB RAM with 64GB storage, 6GB RAM with 128GB storage, and 8GB RAM with 128GB storage. The smartphone can handle games well, but it can get warm if you play games for longer durations. It offers very good battery life, and we could go beyond a day and a half before needing to charge the device again. It has support for 33-watt fast charging, which is very helpful and is capable of topping the device up in about an hour. However, fast charging does cause the phone to get hot. The quad camera setup on the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max is better than the Redmi Note 9 Pro in terms of resolution. The phone manages good shots during the day, but it does sharpen the output. In low light, it manages to keep noise in check, but the night mode does a far better job. Video is stabilized electronically, and the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max does a very good job in daylight. Low light stabilization causes a shimmer effect. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹15,999. Number 4. Motorola One Fusion Plus, ₹17,499. The Motorola One Fusion Plus is a budget offering from the company. This smartphone is among the very few devices to sport a pop-up selfie camera. As a result, it has an all-screen front without any notch or hole punch in its way. The 6.5-inch display on the Motorola One Fusion Plus is an IPS panel and is HDR10 certified. Motorola has also added a loud bottom-firing speaker, which makes this smartphone a good package for viewing content. Powering the Motorola One Fusion Plus is the Qualcomm Snapdragon 730G processor, which is capable of handling day-to-day tasks as well as gaming with ease. It could manage heavy games at high settings without any issues. The One Fusion Plus also packs in a big 5000 mAh battery, which delivered excellent battery life. Charging isn't the fastest using the supplied 18-watt charger, but the phone took around 2 hours to charge completely. Motorola ships the One Fusion Plus with stock Android, which isn't very common. It is very easy to get used to this device. There are no pre-installed apps or bloatware on this device. Motorola One Fusion Plus has a quad camera setup with a 64-megapixel primary camera. It manages good photos in daylight and enables HDR automatically in bright scenes. The macro camera also delivers a good output. In low light, the camera performance is average, but it is improved drastically with night mode enabled. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹17,499. Reminder, watch this video till the end for info about giveaways. Number 3. Samsung Galaxy M31S, ₹19,499. Samsung Galaxy M31S is the successor of the Galaxy M31 and brings new features to the segment. The Galaxy M31S sports a 6.5-inch Infinity O AMOLED display with a hole punch at the center. Just like the Galaxy M31, this too packs a big 6000 mAh battery. But this time around, Samsung has paired a 25 watt charger in the box. Samsung has also gone with a side mounted fingerprint scanner on the Galaxy M31s. The phone has a glass-tick back which looks like glass but is actually made out of plastic. It is a fingerprint magnet and picks up fingerprints very easily. The phone runs on One UI 2.1 on top of Android 10. Samsung has opted for the Equinox 9611 system on chip to power the Galaxy M31s. This is a dated processor at this point, and when you do see some sluggishness while loading heavy apps and games. Battery life on the Galaxy M31s is impressive, as the phone lasted us over 2 days with our usage. The Galaxy M31s has a quad camera setup at the back consisting of a 64 megapixel primary camera. We found the camera performance to be good in daylight. It also has a single take feature which offers different outputs after recording a video. Low light camera performance was average, but we found video stabilization to be poor. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹19,499. Number 2. Realme 7 Pro, ₹19,999. Realme 7 Pro is a spiritual successor to the Realme 6 Pro, boasting of big updates such as an AMOLED display, stereo speakers, and 65-watt fast charging. The Realme 7 Pro features the same mirror split design on its back as the Realme 7, but it's a lot slimmer and lighter, even compared to the Realme 6 Pro. Sadly, this phone ditches one big feature from the Realme 6 Pro, and that's a high screen refresh rate. The Realme 7 Pro performed well as it features the same Qualcomm Snapdragon 720G system on chip. As the 6 Pro, Realme UI ran pretty smoothly without missing a beat. The Super AMOLED display was great for watching videos on, and this experience was enhanced by the stereo speakers. There's a 4500 mAh battery in the Realme 7 Pro, which on average easily lasted for more than a day, starting on a full charge. The rear cameras on the Realme 7 Pro include a 64 megapixel Sony main camera, an 8 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, and a 2 megapixel depth camera and 2 megapixel macro camera. Regular photos taken in daylight generally looked good. HDR was handled well. Details were good and colors looked natural. Low light photos were decent without much visible grain, and every details were fairly good even in darker regions. As of 22nd November 2020, its price in India starts at ₹19,999. Number 1. Poco X3, ₹16,999. Poco X3 smartphone was launched on 22nd September 2020. The phone comes with a 6.67 inch touchscreen display with a resolution of 1080x2340 pixels. Poco X3 is powered by an octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 732G processor. It comes with a 6GB of RAM. The Poco X3 runs Android 10 and is powered by a 6000 mAh battery. The Poco X3 supports fast charging. As far as the cameras are concerned, the Poco X3 on the rear packs a 64 megapixel primary camera, a second 13 megapixel camera, a third 2 megapixel camera, and a fourth 2 megapixel camera. The rear camera setup has autofocus. It sports a 20 megapixel camera on the front for selfies. The Poco X3 runs MIUI 12 based on Android 10 and packs 64GB of inbuilt storage that can be expanded via micro SD card. The Poco X3 is a dual SIM smartphone that accepts nano SIM cards. The Poco X3 weighs 215 grams. It was launched in cobalt blue and shadow gray colors. As of 22nd November 2020, Poco X3 price in India starts at ₹16,999. Now coming to the giveaway, I am conducting a contest for giving free gifts to one of my subscribers. But in order to enter the contest, you have to subscribe to me, click the bell icon and turn on notifications. Then you have to go to the link in description or my website, log in and do the tasks to get free entries. I will tell the gifts in my upcoming videos, so stay tuned. Note: your entries are valid only and only if you subscribe and turn on all notifications. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.